Which of the following produces an optically inactive compound on hydrogenation? And the components in the form of reactants are given by, and the components can be given by, components are given by like this. This is an alkene system followed by a chiral carbon is there. This particular carbon in the beginning case is chiral because it is connected with different groups, like one is methyl, one is hydrogen, one is ethyl followed by one is another one unsaturated system. In the beginning, this starting material is also chiral. Different groups are present. This starting material is chiral and this starting material is also chiral. Like this, these are all chiral alkenes are allowed to react with the hydrogen. Whereas hydrogen addition is SS addition. Hydrogenation is SS addition. So therefore, wherever double bond is there, on the double bond in cis fashion, hydrogen is getting connected over there. Thus, the resulted products of 1 and 2 I will write over here. 3 and 4 I will write at this place. Now, on writing the products, the resultant components appears as, on writing the hydrogenation related product. Now, this is terminal. Now, I am writing it as saturated, followed by, now it is connected with dark side of hydrogen, followed by dotted side methyl, followed by ethyl group. Whereas this particular portion is now connected with hydrogen over here. This is also connected with hydrogen over here. Stereochemistry is not necessary because it is not a chiral part. So therefore, this particular portion ethyl is different. And this propyl is different. Hydrogen as well as methyls are different. Chiral remains as chiral, implies what? Optical active remained as optically active. If I go for the second case, the corresponding product appears as, now here it became saturated, whereas this will become hydrogen and this is becomes what? Methyl. Whereas this isopropyl group, propyl group different, methyl as well as hydrogen different, hence chiral remains as chiral, implies this is optically active, this is also optically active. If I go for my third compound, in this third compound on doing hydrogenation, this particular portion becomes saturated. From the beginning this is chiral, let us look at whether the chirality is maintained or not. This group propyl and this particular 1, 2, 3, that is isobutyl, methyl and hydrogens all are different. Chirality maintained as chirality, hence it is optically active. In the last case, on doing hydrogenation, this particular system remains as it is, followed by this will be hydrogen and this will be methyl. Whereas this left and right groups, see, carbon connected with 2 methyls, carbon connected with 2 methyls. In the beginning it is chiral, but after doing the hydrogenation, this chirality is no more because the left and right groups became same. This is converted as a group present over the chiral carbon. Two groups remain same, implies what? It is having plane of symmetry. Like this, if a plane passes through the hydrogen followed by methyl followed by the carbon, this isopropyl and this isopropyl maintains similarity, that is planarity. Due to having of plane of symmetry, it becomes non-chiral, it becomes achiral. Due to this particular reason, it becomes optically inactive. This will becomes optically inactive. Remaining all are intact, that is remaining all remains as optically active compounds. So therefore, in the hydrogenation, in this case of the given four compounds and the corresponding products, first compound is optically active, remained as optically active. Second compound is optically active, remained as optically active. Third compound is optically active, remained as optically active. Fourth compound in the beginning is optical active, now it became what? Optically inactive on addition of hydrogen. On addition of hydrogen, which is a cis hydrogenation, results as optically inactive compound in the case of 4.